So I have to wear high heels at work all day, and by the time I get home at the end of the day, my feet are killing me.
Sure.
So what do I do?
Why do you have to wear high heels at work?
So I work for Acker, the largest fine and rare wine auction house in the world. So during the day, I just have to stand there and look good.
Anytime you have something like this, it's going to be painful because you're putting a lot of pressure in different areas where our foot just is not in a natural position. So, you know, what we want to do is look at this x-ray here. You can see how these bones are shaped when you're actually in a heel like this. You know, the pain has to be intense. One of the things that you can do at home is you can use a tennis ball. And what you do with the tennis ball is you can actually roll it on the bottom of the foot on your arch, and it can give you that nice massage. You put some nice pressure on there, and it really helps the patient and helps with the pain. How's it feel?
Feels great.
Good. Yeah, I mean, it does help a lot. Another thing you can do when you're having ball of the foot pain, and that's in this area, you know, you can get something that's called a neuroma, and kind of feels like you're walking on a balled up sock, and it can be painful and can be kind of numb sometime, and that's a pinched nerve. So that's inflammation. So what you want to do is you can actually take a water bottle from the fridge, you can freeze it in the freezer, and then you can roll that too. So you're getting the massaging properties of the tennis ball, and then
frozen water will take down the inflammation.
Yeah, the anti-inflammatory properties of the ice.
So how many hours a day can you successfully wear high heels, or is it just...
I mean,
there's no good answer.
There really isn't. It really just depends on your comfort level. Look, yeah. If something hurts, take it off. But you do have to be fashionable at certain times, and you have to dress the part. And, you know, I get that. And if you feel good, you know, do it. It's okay. But, you know your limitations.
I'm having trouble with my arches. I'm in a lot of pain, and I just don't know what's causing it.
Okay. So this is the classic thing that we see all the time. Mm-hmm. When you have arch pain, everyone deals with this from time to time. We all have either high arch, flat arch, you know, normal, regular arch. This can be one of the things that we really want to watch. So what I always tell people to do is when they're at home, you can have a water basin here, put a little water in it, and if you just step your foot in that and then you place it on the cardboard, we'll actually see the exact arch type that she has. And we'll all see this when we go to the pools with friends and we're walking around and we're comparing each other's feet. In her case, she has a higher type of arch. So every step she takes, you know, it's a lot higher than just, say, a regular arch. A flatter soled shoe for a high arch person, you know, like this, you know, this is cork, this is leather. These are all very flat. You know, it's not really going to support the type of arch that you have, as we just proved with this water test. So you can go to any drugstore that you have, and anything with a good solid arch support is great for you. You know, anytime you have something like this, a custom version that you would go to your local podiatrist is, you know, the best thing. Anything custom is usually better.
Shoes with arches. Like even high-heeled shoes,
yes.
Some of them are built with arches in them.
Just a better shoe that has a, you know, a good arch, like Rachel said, is, you know, very good too. So that's what you do.
LaToya's in flip-flops too. What's your foot issue?
I'm prone to athlete's foot, and I want to know, like, what's causing it, or what are some ways that I can deal with it at home?
Oh, good one.
For sure. Yeah. Look, everyone probably has that athlete's foot in their life. Athlete's foot is actually a fungus. So you want to kill that fungus, you know, for a variety of different reasons. But when you have fungus, it sometimes can be dry, cracked, and it can become painful and itchy, which is really annoying. So what we want to do is some at-home tips and treatments. You can actually use apple cider vinegar. And if you put that in a little bit of water, what you'll do is soak your feet for about 15 minutes per day. And that will really help kill the fungus. I mean, nothing's going to definitely take over what a doctor's going to prescribe you. That will cure the fungus a lot faster. But really what you want to watch for is like a warm, moist environment when you're in your sneakers or at the gym. You just want to make sure.
I was going to say, it's athlete's foot because you get it at the gym, right?
Sometimes you can get it there. It's really sweaty socks, sweaty shoes. So you want to make sure that you're not in those for long periods of time. And if you do have a sweatier type of foot, you can wear baby powder, put a little in your shoes, and that will really wick up that moisture.
That's a good,
yeah.
That's simple advice.
It's pretty simple.
Thank you, Dr. Brad.